Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In chapter 9, we will talk about exception handling. In section 9.1, we need to know what is exception, what is the meaning of it, and how can we find output of these small examples. So exception in Java. Exception in Java is where we signal the occurrence of unusual event during program execution. And then we need to throw an exception. So we need to create the exception object. And then we need to handle the exception. So we need some coding that will detect that there is an error and we have to deal with the exception. Let's start with this small example. We need to enter the number of ITCS114 student. And then we will read the number from the user. And then we will ask the user for how many sections. So for example, we have two. Then what we need to do, we need to do the average of number of students in a section. So 30 over 2 is 15. So to write this small program, usually we start with a scanner. We will ask the user for how many students, read number of students, save it in a variable st, and then ask for how many section, read the number of section and save it in a variable section. And then to calculate the average, we divide number of students over number of section, and we just output over the output will be the number of students. So here if we have number of students 30 and number of section 2, we will have the output as 15. Now assume that by mistake the user input the number of section as 0. So assume instead of 2 we have 0. We will come across this statement where we calculate the average, and the average equals student over number of section. This is will be divided by 0, and this is will cause your program to stop running, and you will not have any output from the program. So we need to handle this error, and there are many ways, and we will do one of them as exception. So we will have the same program. We will ask the user for values. We will calculate the average and we will output the average, but we will add some more statements. We will say that because we may have some error within this coding, we need to add the try block. So we will need to have a try bracket. So we'll have a try opening a bracket. We will have all of our coding and then the closing bracket and then end of a try. Just before this statement, which we may have an error here, if we divide by 0, we will have an if statement beforehand that says if section is 0, because this is where we may have an error, we will throw a new exception and we need to display this message, exception divide by 0. So if you have an error, it will come to this block. So you will need to write another block catch between a bracket exception e opening a bracket system.out.println e.getMessage. So this message exception divided by 0, it will come there and we will output the message. Let's try it with some input and output. Let's do the following. So we will start from the beginning. We have a scanner. We will enter the try block and we will ask the user for values and we will save the value inside st. So if we just have it small like this, so we will ask the user for values and we will take the value 30 and we will save it in a variable st. Then we will ask the user for number of section and we will read the number of section. So we will read number of section and this one will be saved in a variable section. Now we will come to this if statement. If section equals 0, in our case section is 2, is not 0, so we will not do the if and we will continue normally. So we will calculate the average and we will display the average. So we will just calculate the average and display the average as 15. Because everything went normally with the try block, it means we will not execute the catch block. So the idea says, if everything goes normally as expected within the try block, you should ignore the catch block. Now let's do the other way around. Let's assume that we have another input and we have some errors and we need to handle the division by 0. So let's assume we have another thing. Sorry. So let's assume we will start from the beginning. We will start with the try block, and we will ask the user enter the values, and we will save it. So we will read the values, and number of students will be 30. Ask the user for number of section and read the number of section. So we will read the number of section, and this time let's assume the input as 0. Now we will come to this if statement that says if section equals 0, and this is a true. So what we need to do, we need to throw a new exception. So we will mention throw a new exception, exception divide by 0. This means you have to finish your try block. It's more like a break in the for loop. So do not execute whatever remaining in the try block. So in the remaining of a try block, we have these two statements. So we will not calculate the average. We will not do the output. As soon as you have the exception, you have to go and you have to jump to the catch block. So we will go to the catch block, and we will need to display this message. And this message will say exception divide by 0. So if you have an exception in your try block, ignore whatever there in the try block and go to the catch block, and then from there you need to display a message or execute whatever statement you have in the catch block. So let's do one more thing. We will change the previous program to handle two exceptions instead of one. For division by 0, and this is already done. And the second thing, for negative values. So if the user enter a negative value for number of section, we will display a message that number of section is negative. If the number of section is 0, we will display a message we cannot divide by 0. So just like what we did previously, always we will keep reading the similar data. Now instead of having one if condition, we will have two if condition. One of them is to handle if it is by 0, and the second one to handle if it is a negative number. If it is less than 0, we should have the following message, divide by 0. If it is negative, we will have the other message about negative. In both cases, if it is 0 or if it is negative, it means that we will go to the catch, or to the catch block. So in both cases, in these two F, if they are true, we will jump to the catch block and we will output the message within the statement. So let's do a small input and output if we have negative values. So let's assume the number of students is 30, but number of section is minus 2. So it means we will execute the else F, and we will say if section is less than 0, which is yes, throw a new exception. So we will throw this an exception by going to the catch block. Within the catch block, we have to display the message that we just sent from the if statement. So we will output the following message. So in general, let's think about it in this way. If an exception occurs with the try block, the rest of the block is ignored. If you have an exception within your try block, whatever there in the try block, you have to ignore it and you have to go to the catch block. If no exception is occurring within the try block, the catch block are ignored. The other way around, if no exception, no errors in the try block, then you continue normally with the try block, but you have to ignore the catch block. Again, here we have a small output just to make sure that we know the meaning of the try and block, try and catch a block, and when each one should be executed. So let's do the following. So let's start by saying I have x equal 10. My statement now will start as follow. Do the output of a statement start. So we will do output start, and then we will start the try block. The boundaries of a try block, these are the boundaries of the try block. Now, once we enter the try block, we will output a message try. So we will output a message try. And then we have an if statement. If x equals 0, in our case, x is 10. So we will not do the if statement. And I will go normally with my try block. We will calculate R. R 100 over x, which is 10, So in this case, R will be 10. Output the value of R, so the output will be 10. Now, once we finish the try block, because we want normally with the try block, no exception was there, which means the catch block should not be executed. It should be ignored. But we have at the end, at the out of the catch block, because these are the boundaries of the catch block. Just at the end of the program, we have another statement that says end, so we will output end. So we have a start. This is coming before the try block. We have a try. This is inside the try block. R equal 10 inside the try block because everything went normally. We didn't do the catch. We went to the end of the program and we output end. Now let's do the same thing, but this time we will do it with x equals 0 just to make sure that we know how to do the execution if we have an exception. So we will start, but we will mention that x now as 0. Now our first statement, do the output of a start. That's why we have the output here as a start. Start your try block. So again, remember, this is the boundary of your try block and this is the boundary of your catch block. Starting the try, you have to output a message try. So you will output a try. Go and check if x is 0. Currently x is 0. So you will output a message error. We will throw a new exception error. Now, because we have an exception, it means I have to go to the catch block and I will never execute the remaining of the try block. Here we have an exception, e.getMessage. This will display the message error. And then once we finish the catch block, we will output a message end. So we will have a message end. The purpose of catch and a try, an exception, is to handle unexpected events, unusual events in your program. And this is will be much clearer when we start chapter 10, when we talk about how to read from files and how to output into files. Because in files, we may have exception like file is not found or file is not accessible. So we need to handle this exception, and that's why we need a try and catch. So the main aim of this session is to know what are the meaning of a try and catch, and if you have an output, how to execute the output. And then in chapter 10, we will need to use them to deal with files. As an example, I need you to try this. This is a small coding where you have a try catch and you have initial variable wait time with the initial value 46. Try to execute the coding and find what is the output. And then if you change the value from 46 to 12, again, try to execute the code and find what is the output. We have this question. This is one of the previous tests that is available on your Teams. And it says, consider the following coding. We have an array. We have a try and catch block. We have statements, and then we have to find the output. So the coding starts by declaring an array. We have integer bracket list, new integer 4. So I'm declaring an array, and the size of the array is 4 elements. And then we have initialization. In location 0, I should have 10. In location 1, we should have 15. In location 2, we have 30. In location 3, we have 5. So our array, we will have 10, 15, 30, and 5. So we have an array of size 4 elements, and then the initialization was done such that we have the following values. Now the next statement, system.out.println myList. So we will have this message, myList. And then we will start the try block. So again, we have to remember to check the boundary of the try block. This is the opening of the try and this is the close of the try. So these are the statements that are within the try block. So the idea says if we go through try block smoothly and we have no exception, then we will continue with the try block and we will ignore the catch. If we have any exception within a try, then we have to ignore the try, the remaining of the try block, and then we need to go to the catch exception. So we will start by saying I equals 0. So the initial value of I as location 0. I should be less than the length of the array, which is 4. So this is a true. Now, do the output of the element at location I. The element at location I is 10. So the first output will be 10. If less at location I is greater than 20, the element at location I currently is 10. Is it greater than 20? It's not. So we will not do the F. I will continue. And then it says list of I plus equal 5. Go to your elements and increment it by 5. So 10 plus 5 should be as 15. Now we are still within the for loop. So again, I have to go and I have to execute the next statement. I will be incremented. So now I will be moving to the next value, which is 1. And then 1, is it less than the length? True. We will come inside. What is the value, output the value of list at location 1? List at location 1 is 15, so we will output 15. If the element at location 1 is greater than 20, 15, is it greater than 20? It's not, so we will not do any exception. But I have to increment by 5, so we will go to 15, incremented by 5, and it should be as 20. Again, I have to go to the beginning of the loop and go to the next I. So with the next I, we will have the value 2. 2, is it with less than length? True. Then I have to do the following. Again, the statement says we have to output the value at the current I. The current I is 2. The value is 30. So we will output 30. If the element at location I greater than 20, the element at location I is 30. 30 greater than 20, true. Which means I have to execute this statement and I have to ignore anything within the try block. So we will ignore the increment, we will ignore the for loop, and we will just go to the exception. When we go to the exception, we will output a message invalid. So that's why we have here invalid. Once you finish your catch, you will go, because this is the boundaries of the catch, so we will go to the end of the catch. We have a for loop and we need to output the elements in the array. So the elements in the array, we should have 15, 20, 30 and 5. That's why we have the output as follow. So here also the idea is we have a try and catch. We executed the try. When everything was going normally, we just executed the for loop by going through the elements. Whenever we have an element that is greater than 20, then here it says through new exception. So it's more like you need to exit the try loop, and the try block, and then you need to go to the catch. And from there, you have to continue with your program.